Darkness never conquered. At the end of that time, he was hungry. The tempter you are the Son of God. Command these stones to be made bread.
It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
If you are the Son of God, cast yourself down, for it is written, he shall give his angels charge concerning you, and in their hands they shall bear you up for fear you may strike your foot against the stone.
It is written again, you shall not tempt the Lord your God.
All these things I will give you. All these things, if you will only follow me.
Go away. It is written, you shall worship the Lord your God. Come on.
Thank you. Then Jesus went with Jairus to his house.
When Jesus got there, he let no one go in with him except Peter, James, and John, the child's father and mother. The rest of the household were crying for the dead girl. Jesus said,
"Don't cry.
She is not dead.
She is asleep."
Jesus took hold of the girl's hand and called her.
"Get up, get up, get up. Get up, my child."
And she did. There were 12 baskets of food left over. People thought, "What a wonderful miracle."
And it was. But there were two miracles that day. The feeding of the 5,000 was one.
He knew so much that we couldn't know, but I'm speaking of an impending death. He told us about it several times, but it always seemed to be a parable he was telling, some far distant thing that could never frighten or threaten us. For the time for Passover was near, and Jesus wanted us all to celebrate it together. So we gathered and had the last meal that we would have in person.
The huge stone was rolled away, and the grave was empty. Mary Magdalene was still so wrapped up in her grief over the death of Jesus that she didn't think that someone had stolen his body. Not only had they robbed her of the life of this man, but they had even robbed the grave.
Tears flooded her eyes. She stumbled out into the garden sobbing. And she stopped. Mary.